There are certain easy-to-use features in Apple's Motion and Final Cut Pro 10 that don't quite work the same way as in Adobe Premiere Pro or After Effects. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you a few ways to make them work as they do in our Final Cut Pro tutorials. Our plugin effects will only work on the Mac Creative Cloud versions. As you may have seen in our tutorials, many of our plugins are generators that are designed to be just applied on top of the video as its own piece of a video. But there is no such thing as a generator plugin in Premiere Pro. So we have to take a slightly different approach. In Premiere Pro, the first thing I need to do is create a transparent video clip. This new transparent video clip will show up in your bin and is what we will use to hold any of our effects. We can put it on a new layer above the video, just as if it was a generator. In the case of our blaster bolt effect, I only want the laser blast to last for 3 frames. So I just edit a few frames on top of our video clip where I want the laser bolt to appear. Now just open the Effects tab, and turn down the Found Film Effects category. All of our generator effects will show up beside standard filter effects. I'm gonna drag the blaster bolt to my transparent video clip, and now I basically have a generator effect. In After Effects, the process is similar, except instead of a transparent video, I will create a new solid above my video. Use the same process for any of our other generators, like Sabreblade, and just stretch or trim the length of the solid or transparent layer to the length you need. Another weird quirk of the Adobe apps is that you won't see on-screen controls until you actually select the effect name in the effect control panel. Unfortunately, we can't make the control points green and red like in the Apple apps, so you will have to be careful and keep track of which is which. The rest of the controls, including keyframe, basically work the same way. You can even copy and paste your transparent video clips once the effect is applied to save time. Just follow our Final Cut Pro tutorials for how to use the specific controls in our effects, but apply the effects using the methods I just showed you. Thanks, and may the force be with you.